Hi there, this is Steph from eMagCreator. This tutorial will explain how to add actions to your eMag that are triggered when a specified event occurs. I will give examples of a timer with a pop-up message, mouse click navigation, and how to add a mouse over tooltip. First off, I will show you how to create a simple mouse click navigation event. I've made a small arrow and want to make the eMag flip to the next page when the arrow is clicked. To do this, I will select the arrow and go to Properties. After clicking on the Events tab, I will choose Mouse Click and then select Go to Next Page under the Navigation folder. If you now preview it, you will see that clicking the arrow takes you to the next page. Next, I will add a mouse over tooltip to the eMag. I want to add more information to the same arrow to let readers know what the arrow is for. To do this, I need to go back into the Events tab. This time, it will be a mouse over event. Under Interface and Windows, I will select Show Tooltip. Then, add in the text you would like and hit Finish. The second part of this event is to stop the tooltip when the mouse leaves the arrow. To do this, choose Mouse Out. Under Interface and Windows, this time choose Hide Tooltip. You can preview your changes. Finally, I will explain how to make a pop-up message based on a timer that starts as the eMag is opened. This could be useful if you want to limit access to non-paying readers or show an advertisement or announcement. With nothing selected except the layer, go into Properties. Choose eMag Loaded, and under Advanced, choose Create Timer. Name the timer, and choose its duration. Now, choose Timer Finished. Type the timer name that you just created. Under General, choose Display Message. You'll be prompted to edit the message. This can be just text, or it can be HTML. You also have the option to freeze the eMag and to allow readers to close the message. Since I'm looking to limit access to non-paying readers, I will choose to freeze the eMag and to not allow them to close the message. You can now preview your timer. This concludes the tutorial on events. There are endless ways to use events, and it takes some time to find out which events suit your needs best. Make sure to check out our other tutorials, such as the Introduction to the Toolbox. Bye for now!